So good morning. Everybody can see my slides. My name is Kate Stevens, and I am your host this morning for Good Morning Howard, which is brought to you by The Village in Howard. The Village in Howard is here with the purpose of helping senior citizens across Howard County to age in place and to live our best lives. So we have a lot of activities that we have available for members and for people in the community. On Mondays, we have morning meanderings. That's an in-person gathering of folks at Lake Elkhorn, and coffee with friends, which is virtual. On Tuesday, the bridge group meets in person. And then Tuesday mornings, we have a Tai Chi group. The theme changes from week to week, but that's hosted by Fran Dummett. On Wednesdays, we have a lunch bunch who meets in person and a lunch bunch who meets virtually. So you can tell this is a pretty active group, because on Thursday in the evening, there's also a Tai Chi. It's a repeat of whatever the theme was on the previous Tuesday. On Friday, we have a virtual Mahjong. And then Saturdays, join us at the Lake in Kitimukundi for sneakers and coffee. Again, the group gets together. Folks are welcome to join and walk with everybody. In addition, we have some special programs that come up every month. And if you're interested in these programs, you can go to our website, The Village in Howard. Go to the events calendar where you can get details and register. On May 4th, we have Remarkable Reads. That's my personal favorite. It's not a book club per se. I don't have to dissect the characters. I just tell you if I like the book and what I liked about it. On May 5th, we have a meetup for arts and crafts and projects. They actually meet several times a month, but whether you're crocheting, working on your computer, painting, bring it to our office at the Village in Stevens Forest, and you can just join the group. On May 9th, happy hour is going to be at the Turn House. Please come out and join us. I know some people will go for lighter fare or for dinner, but either way, we'd love to see you. On May 11th, keep up with technology. Always changing, always something new to learn, whether it's Zoom or how to project a video on your TV. Joy is setting those up, so please join us for that. On May 16th, My 3 Cents will have a very interesting topic. It's who should have input into what students are taught. This will just be an open conversation. It's virtual, but again, this is something you can register for on our website. We have our annual 50-50 raffle coming up. There are only 300 tickets that will be sold. So the maximum amount to win would be, I think, $7,500, if I'm doing my math this morning. But there are still tickets available for purchase. If you go on the website and look for the 50-50 raffle, you can get details on how you can do that. Now, Good Morning Howard has two more programs after this coming up in May. On May 10th, we will have the Howard County General Hospital Community Care Team. These folks take care of us when we're discharged from the hospital. So I think it's really important for all of us to learn about what they can do. There are healthcare workers, health nurses, social workers, but it's the sort of thing before we need it, we would like to know what's available to us and how to take advantage of that resource. On May 24th, I'm reaching out to everybody to tell us what vacations are planned for this summer. Where are you going? Where have you been? Share photos of previous vacations. We're going to be on hiatus for Good Morning Howard so that we can all get out now that we can get out and enjoy wherever you've traveled. So please, if you have photos, travel tips, let me know, and we'll add that to the program. If you'd just like to come and talk about where you've been or where you're going, we'd love to hear from you. As a reminder, TVIH has Good Morning Howard at 9 o'clock on Wednesday mornings via Zoom. This is open to members and guests. Our sessions are recorded, and they can be viewed by TVIH members. So this morning, we're welcoming United States Representative John Sarbanes. He represents Maryland's 3rd Congressional District. He's joined our Zoom this morning. And before we introduce Congressman Sarbanes, I'd like to introduce our host for this morning, Debbie Bergio. Debbie is the executive director of the Village in Howard. She joined us about a month ago, in March, almost 2 months ago. But she's the founder and president of Winter Grace Senior Ministries, as well as our executive director. So Debbie is well known around Howard County. And I'll just put in a little plug. There's going to be a 50-plus resource event going on, a fair at Cornerstone Church in Columbia on May 20th. Debbie will be there, and we'd like to have a TVIH table. So if you're interested in doing that, please reach out to her. So at this point, as a reminder, if you have questions throughout the program, please put them in chat. And then at the end of our speaking portion, we'll have a little Q&A. So I'm going to turn this over to Debbie. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Kate, for all that information about all the great things going on here at the Village and for hosting us this morning. We are so happy to have Congressman Sarbanes with us this morning. Congressman represents the 3rd Congressional District of Maryland, which now, after this last election, now encompasses all of Howard County. So all of our members of the Village are represented by Mr. Sarbanes. He is appointed to the House Committee on Energy and Commerce and serves on subcommittees of energy, climate, and grid security, and the environment, manufacturing, and critical minerals. Mr. Sarbanes was born and raised in Maryland, lives in Maryland, and has that convenience of being, and the benefit of being able to go home each and every day to be with family and meet with his constituents, hear from them, and we can hear from him. And we're just really happy that your office reached out to the Village. Just really glad that we can have this conversation and hear about all of the things that you were involved in Congress that help seniors not only just survive, but thrive, because our mission at the Village is for seniors across Howard County to thrive, aging in place, and just what we would love to talk more about. So thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks so much, Debbie. I appreciate being here. And I was saying to Vicki a little while ago that I thought I knew a good deal about your organization, but that was a terrific overview from Kate with all of the amazing activities that not only keep the individuals that are sort of directly benefiting from them engaged, but altogether represent a contribution to the broader community. Because when you stay active and you stay involved, it lifts up the entire community, in this case, Howard County. So I want to thank you for the good work that you do and for the clearly broad participation that you have. Health, a few issues and stress and so forth. Actually, I just read, some of you may have seen it, that the Surgeon General of the United States has identified loneliness as one of the most significant sources of stress that we're feeling as Americans. He describes his own bout with loneliness. And we know that there's a whole area of research and study and awareness of how loneliness can present challenges for older Americans. And what can we do to address that? Coming together, shared activity, it's all part of us connecting to each other as human beings. And that can provide a great source of comfort for each of us. And again, for our extended families, knowing that connection is there and is in place.